Three, two, one. Hello, everybody. My name is Stone Mountain 64, and we are here in the Liberation map. Now, the other map that came out accompanying this in the first Modern Warfare 3 release of maps was Piazza, which I also did a walkthrough through. If you guys want to check that out, there will be an annotation on top as well as a link at the end. But let's get it started here in Liberation. Now, Liberation is a little bit larger than Piazza. It's not an extremely large map, but it is larger. The guns of choice, I'm going to be talking about the guns that I would use, the best things to know, and what you're going to see in the video here is I'm going to stick around on this one third of the map, then I'm going to head to the middle, show you the middle part of the map, and the other side. The thing about this is going to be perfect if you guys are looking to know the maps, like, perfectly know them very well without having to go into a map and destroy your KD if you're a KD player, or your win-loss, or something like that. If you guys need just more detail on a map, then these are the perfect video just to watch. I don't know if other people do this, but this is what I do whenever I head into new map packs that are released. It is the best way to go into it, I can guarantee you. Go and roam around in a private match on your own, or just watch something like this. Like I was saying, this is going to be perfect. So I'm going to go through everywhere like I was saying. I'll start in this one third of the map where I spawn and show you all the different areas that Infinity Ward created. Now the perfect gun that I'm going to be using, and I would recommend you guys to use, would be something like the SCAR, something like the ACR. You're going to stick around the assault rifle category because that's what's going to be the primary thing to do. If you're a sniper, snipers will work well. Also, there's no real best sniper, I guess. I mean, it's whatever people prefer. Some people like the bolt action, but anyways, assault rifles are going to be what you're going to want to stick with on this map, in my opinion. We'll see how it goes, and I'll probably keep you guys updated with my videos, commentaries, letting you know what I think about it. But for now, the assault rifle has been treating me well, and it is going to be probably the best thing to use. MP7 would be a good gun as well. That is just a diverse, wonderful gun. That's the gun I recommended for Piazza. And like I said in the other video, it was the first gun that I actually unlocked my prestige token with. So this was all pre-recorded. This is on a side note, by the way. Talking more about the map. Here, there's an underground portion. This was where I originally spawned. You can go up to the main spawn here, as well as over to the side for a flank route right here where there is a turret actually mounted up. So if you need to, you can hop on that. Really don't see a lot of use for that, and I would not recommend those ever. But, you know, some people like to get that challenge for 5 kills streak with it or something like that. This is the side bridge. I don't remember if I mentioned this earlier, but there's 3 bridges. There's one here, one in the middle with a flaming car, and there is a far side one, which really doesn't have too much use. It's got that pipe going under it like you saw earlier. This is the first one third of the map. This is a lot more of a secure area. Personally, I think it is behind, you know, it's got the building, it's got a lot more cover. On the other side, when I get to that, you'll notice that it's a lot more open. There's a second level that looks like you can go up there. When I first saw it, I thought you could go up there, but you cannot, and it seems a lot more open. It does have a back area where there's a lot of stuff. A lot of people will probably be hiding there. If you're going to do a if you're going to do a hiding master type thing, that's going to be a good place to go. Here's the flaming car on the bridge. There's a few good head glitching places that I don't really I might show a few of them here, but I actually did not go into extreme detail on that. You guys can find that. I'm sure T-Mart will do something about that. He's great with those. I actually love watching his stuff on that because it helps me out a lot. But here is back over on the third bridge. Now this is, you can go under this one with the pipe as well as around on the left side for an extreme flank route. This is going to be really great where I'm running right here. You can run all the way over on the side if you're playing something like Domination, need to get around without being seen. That is a really great thing. And what Infinity Ward does, which a lot of people don't actually agree with me on this, I actually did a Black Ops versus Modern Warfare 3 thing where I talked about the differences between the maps and what I thought about it. I think there's a lot more clutter on these types of maps. This is just my opinion here, but in Black Ops there's 3 lanes basically on pretty much every map. Like Radiation, there's 3 lanes in the building, in the middle, or on the right where the switch was, and then you can go underground for one route. And that was just simple. There's a few things around, but on this, when I push start, I'll show you guys the map and stuff like that. There is just stuff everywhere, and there's 10 different routes you can take. It makes it a lot more confusing, which, you know, it's got its pros and its cons. If you can understand it, you know where everything is. If you spawn somewhere, you know where you are, and you know where the enemy is relative to where you are by, you know, looking at where your teammates are, etc., then you're going to have the jump, and you'll be facing the enemy if they come up on you, or you'll be hitting them in the back. Right here, this is the back part of the enemy spawn relative to where I spawned. Now, this is a lot. I thought you can get up there at first, but you can't. Then even those stairs right there are also blocked off, so you're going to need to stay either over on the right where I just shot, or over on the other side, which I'll get to later. But there's a lot less cover compared to the other side where there's the missiles. There's a lot more stuff you can hide behind and a lot more places to head glitch and take cover, whereas this is just more of an open area. It's got the fountain in the middle, but it's really not too much cover, and I think this is where assault rifles are really going to make their day. Something like an ACR, possibly suppressed, even though the suppressor takes a lot of range off of it, it's still a good gun and it's still extremely accurate. If you're a good sniper, you are going to love this map because there's a lot of long line of sights. Even just in this area, you can see all the way over there. You can see all around this. If you go up in this hut, there is a lot of open opportunities. If you are caught with a shotgun in the middle there, you're going to be taken out. So coming back here, I was just checking this area out. Really not much here. You can go up behind this tank here, maybe a little bit of cover, possibly a head glitching spot, and yeah, but this is the final third of the map. I think I just go back over to the middle right now, but that is pretty much everything. There might be something I missed or something like that, but if you watch this a few times, you can get this down. And if you know where the enemy's coming from, I guarantee you, you're going to have the jump. And that's what you're really going to want. Now, keep in mind, though, these are the people that are currently going to be playing it are the people who are tryhard, who bought the premium thing, and, you know, they're good players. So that means if you don't have it, you might actually be at an advantage. Something in Black Ops that I did was I deleted all my map packs that I got. I got them all. But at the end of the game, I deleted them all so I could play with all the noobs who didn't really care that much about the game to buy it. So just food for thought, you guys. Otherwise, that's pretty much it for this map. Hope you enjoyed it. If you want to see the other one, I'll put a link at the end. Peace out, guys.